Video number 25, Introduction to Panel Data Models. So in panel data introduction, we'll discuss what is panel data, what's the difference between micro panel data and macro panel data. In these 3-4 videos, we'll discuss only micro panel data. What are fixed effect models? What are random effect models? When we should use fixed effect models, when we should use random effect models, why we should not use fixed effect models and use random effect models or vice versa. And last video will be on workshop on panel data using R and Stata. So, panel data. So, a panel data, or its another name is longitudinal data, is one where you have repeated observations on the same units, objects, entities, subjects at regular intervals of time. Cross-sectional data, where you have data at a point in time. Time series data, where you have data at regular intervals of time. Panel data is combination of both. The unit may be individual, household, enterprises, countries, or any other entities that remain stable through time. There is National Longitudinal Survey of Youth. That's data discussed by Christopher Dougherty in Introduction to Econometrics book. We'll discuss with this data as well as Stock and Watson data. Balanced panel, where every unit is surveyed in every period time period. If data are unbalanced, if you have some individuals who have not been interviewed in some years. What are the merits of panel data? That's very important. If you recall my video on internal and external threats to an econometric model, there were 5 threats to an internal validity of a model. One was omitted variable bias, other was second one was sample selection bias, errors in variable, simultaneous causality, and probably a wrong functional form. So panel data basically addresses your omitted variable bias. So that's one of the objective. Then it helps you in exploring dynamics. For example, from cross-sectional data, we can find out what is frictional unemployment, what is structural unemployment, and what is, you can say, long-term unemployment. But you cannot see its dynamics just from cross-sectional data. So how you can explore this dynamic, these dynamics? You can, you need this panel data. Another advantage that you have number of observations enlarged because you have n cross-sectional units in t time periods. For example, if you have 200 districts and you have data for 7 time periods, so you have 1400 observations. Because they tend to be extensive to undertake, they are often well designed and high response rates, but its cost is also very high. So some notations for panel data: I is for entity, subjects, individual, country, like that. So small s, n is number of entities. T is for number of time periods. Capital T is total number of time periods. So if you have two variables, XIT, YIT, I is for cross-sectional unit, T is for time period. Let's consider an example. What's this example and how it resolve our issue of omitted variable bias that we are going to look into? And this is chapter 10 example from Stock and Watson, Introduction to Econometrics. We have data on 48 US states, 7 years data. It's a balanced panel, so total number of observations are 336. So whether beer tax leads to increase in beer tax leads to low traffic fatality rate, traffic deaths per 10,000 state residents. So basically, now we are going to explore this question. Some other variables are there: legal drinking age, 18 years, 21 years, 20 years, drinking driving laws. So it is said that a person in US is 13 times more likely to have fatal accident if he or she is legally overdrunk. So if you look at beer tax and fatality rate, so what do we see? That as we increase beer tax per case, fatality rate increases. Amazing. So if you want to decrease death rates, decrease beer tax. It's very naive. It's very simple. It's simple to reach at such results. And this is often the case when we've done simple regressions. Look at 1988 data. Again, if you increase beer tax, there will be more fatal accidents. That's again, what's wrong? We face such problems in many other economic issues as well. When price of gasoline increase, gasoline per capita consumption decrease. That's given in green econometric analysis, but basically some other variables are there. So listen my lecture on inclusion and exclusion of irrelevant variables and relevant variables. Now, let's see what happens. You have some other omitted factors, and if they are unobserved, that's very important thing to know. The culture around driving and drinking. How can you compare culture or mayor culture of Mumbai, Karachi, Dhaka, New York, London? It's difficult to measure culture. It's unobserved. Density of cars on the roads, quality of automobiles. So these are the other potential variables which should have been in the model. But if a variable should have been in the model and it's unobserved, then what we can do? So that's what we are going to see here. So you have all these variables like traffic density, you have culture attitudes towards drinking and driving. So if you have bad driving culture, subcontinent, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, so you will have more traffic deaths. So they are also where you have such cultural differences, you may impose high taxes. So now this ZI is unobserved. That's interesting. Basically issue is this ZI is unobserved. If you have data, yes, include it and run simple regression. But if you don't have data, what to do? Now you see, you have this fatal accident fatality rate regressed on beer tax and ZI, which is omitted variable, unobserved variable, but important, but we don't have data. You have 1982, and we have seen in both cases beta 1 is positive. Now we want to see that whether increase in beer tax from 1982 to 1988 leads to lowering of death from 1982 to 1988. That's what we need to see. So if we subtract second equation from the first one, so you see this omitted variable, which we assume will not change over time. Your eating culture, your breakfast culture will not change within a period of 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. So this is unobserved, but and if you have it for two periods, and when you will subtract second from first, this effect will be no more there. So though it is omitted, but its impact will be eliminated. So we'll see that whatever is left out, that is because of this tax rate. So fatal accident rates, we have seen this one, and now we have subtracted second from first, and we got this equation. You see, ZI will cancel out. New error term is also uncorrelated with beer tax. Difference equation, we'll call it difference in difference equation at some other stage, and we'll discuss it in detail where we'll discuss randomized controlled trials. But at the moment, let's live with this. No, you have positive, and this one is significant as well. And Here you have negative, so it means if you increase beer tax from 1988 to 1982 to 1988, there will be decrease in deaths due to increase in beer tax. So that makes sense, and we have now this regression. We have this analysis where we have change in beer tax from between two time periods leads to lowering of fatal accidents between two time periods. So change in beer tax leads to a change in fatality rate as per your theory, as per your expectation. And so now question is, we will estimate this model and we'll discuss where we need to use fixed effect model, random effect model. What is fixed effect model? What is random effect model? What is OLS, pooled estimation? And in what situations we should use? That will be our next video. Please stay tuned. And the third video will be how to estimate these models using Stata and R. Thank you for watching. Take care.